Hi everybody, hope you are all fine. This is Atik. Welcome to our YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Now let me focus on what is unguided media. So already in my previous session I have discussed about what is guided media and what are the types of guided media in computer networks. Unguided medium transport electromagnetic waves without using a physical conductor. So there is no involvement of any physical media in this. Is it okay? That is the first point. This type of communication is often referred to as wireless communication. Why we are saying it as a wireless? There will be no physical connectivity among the devices. That's why we are calling it as wireless communication. Next point, signals are normally broadcast through free space and thus are available to anyone who has a device capable of receiving them. Is it right? This is one of the big advantages of wireless communication. Okay, that's what unguided media will do. Unguided signals can travel from the source to the destination in several ways. One way is we can make use of ground propagation, sky propagation, and line of sight propagation. These are the various ways in which the data can be transmitted. Okay. Now, these are the three types of unguided media that I am going to explain in my today's session. One is radio waves, microwaves, and infrared waves. The unique feature about all these three unguided medias is they are wireless. So there is no involvement of any type of physical connectivity that we need to understand. Is it okay? So the first one, radio waves. Let me discuss about what is radio waves. Electromagnetic waves ranging in frequencies between 3 kilohertz and 1 gigahertz are normally called radio waves. So dear students, as we are talking about the wireless communication, we need to understand the frequencies here. So if the frequency is ranging, if the electromagnetic waves frequency is ranging between 3 kHz and 1 GHz, then it is normally radio waves. Okay. Radio waves for the most part are omnidirectional. You know, this is one of the unique feature of this radio waves. They are omnidirectional. You know what is the meaning of omnidirectional? Omnidirectional means the data can be transmitted in any direction. There is no specific direction here for radio waves. See here, when an antenna transmits radio waves, they are propagated in all directions. So if an antenna is transmitting the radio waves, we don't know where the radio waves will go. They can go in any direction or they can go in all directions. So this is one of the unique feature of radio waves. Radio waves, particularly those waves that propagate in the sky mode, can travel long distances. This makes radio waves a good candidate for long distance broadcasting such as AM radio. So this is one of the big advantage of radio waves. They have a unique quality of traveling for longer distances. When you make the radio waves to go in the sky, they can go at a longer distances, and which makes them to make use of, which makes them to be making use in the AM radio as well. That's what the advantage of radio waves is all about. Okay, next, radio waves use omnidirectional antennas that send out signals in all directions. Now, in order to transmit these radio waves, they can't be transmitted manually. Compulsory, we need to make use of one device, that is an antenna. So which type of antennas should be used to transmit these radio waves? There is a specifically designed antennas known as, we can see here, omnidirectional antennas. These antennas transmit the radio waves in all directions. This is the unique feature of these antennas. Okay, now once radio waves have completed, next I am moving to the second unguided media, that is microwaves. Now how to distinguish a radio waves from microwaves? Here we need to see the frequencies again. Electromagnetic waves having frequencies between 1 and 300 gigahertz are called microwaves. Now you can see here the range of the frequencies have increased here. If the range of the frequencies have increased, then they are microwaves now. If the frequency range is smaller, then they are radio waves. So be very, very careful about the frequencies. Okay. Microwaves are unidirectional. Now this is one unique point, unique feature of microwaves. One is in terms of frequencies. Another unique feature of microwaves are they are unidirectional. Unidirectional means these microwaves can transmit it in only one direction. unlike the radio waves, which are omnidirectional. They can be transmitted in all directions. Microwaves are unidirectional. When an antenna transmits microwaves, they can be narrowly focused. Okay. This means that the sending and receiving antennas need to be aligned. So this is one condition in microwaves transmission. The sending antenna, let us say this is sending antenna and this is receiving antenna. Both these antennas should be aligned like this. For example, sending antenna cannot be a little bit in a different field compared to the receiving antenna. Otherwise, the microwaves cannot be transmitted to the receiver. Sending antenna and receiving antenna both should be aligned in order to make them work and to be transmitted. The unidirectional property has an obvious advantage. What is that obvious advantage? A pair of antennas can be aligned without interfering with another pair of aligned antennas. So I believe that you got a point here. So there is no interference problem because only these two antennas are communicating with each other. For the remaining other pairs of antennas, there will not be any type of disturbance in microwaves transmission. This is one of the advantage. Microwaves need unidirectional antennas that send out signals in one direction. So they may, unlike the radio waves which makes use of omnidirectional antennas, microwaves, they required unidirectional antennas to send signals in one direction. Two types of antennas are used for microwave communications. So here in unit, these are the two unidirectional antennas that can be used for microwave or communications. What are those? One is the parabolic dish and the horn. Okay, what is parabolic dish? You can see here. This is a parabolic dish and this is a horn antenna. So in this way, the data can be, or the microwaves can be transmitted from one device to another device. Next, the third unguided media is infrared waves. Okay, what are infrared waves? I believe that you people have listened this. Infrared waves with frequencies from 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. So wavelengths from 1 mm to 770 nm can be used for short range communication. So if you want any short range communication, then infrared waves are preferred. Infrared waves having high frequencies cannot penetrate walls. As they are having high frequencies, they cannot be penetrated through walls. Now, this advantageous characteristics prevents interference between one system and another. A short range communication system in one room cannot be affected by another system in the next room. So dear students, this is having one big advantage. Infrared waves, if let us say two devices are communicating in one room, then if another two devices are communicating another room by using infrared waves, then there will not be any interference. Why? Their range is very small one. So, and they cannot be penetrated through walls also. So that's why infrared waves are advantageous in short range communication. So now we got, I believe, that a clear picture about these three types of unguided media. What are those? Radio waves, microwaves and infrared waves. So with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon, everybody. Take care. Allah Hafiz.